Armstrong Entertainment. Uh-oh, it's a Jennifer Aniston movie.
Hey everyone, this is Chad from Armstrong Entertainment, and I saw the movie Wanderlust. It stars Paul Rudd, Jennifer Aniston, Justin Theroux, Alan Alda, Malin Ackerman, and a bunch of other... It looks like a bunch of other comedians who have tons of small roles throughout the movie. The cast in this movie is incredible. It's by the writers who did Role Models, which is a movie that came out a few years ago, which I really, really enjoyed. So this one, kind of on the same part. Let me start off by saying I was definitely on the fence of seeing this movie. I wouldn't even say I was on the fence. I was off the fence. I had no intention of seeing this film, but I was like, you know what? It's Friday. I have to see something. And this is the only thing that looked even halfway decent. So I give it a chance. I usually steer away from Jennifer Aniston movies because I don't think her movies are good. Literally one out of every five of her movies I'll probably like. So that's about 20%. Yeah, that's 20%. This movie stars Jennifer Aniston and Paul Rudd. They're a married couple living in New York City. They're kind of on a very tight budget. They don't have a lot of money. Jennifer Aniston's character is very flighty. She doesn't really know what she wants to do with her life. Paul Rudd's character gets fired, so they literally have no jobs between the two of them. They can't live in New York City, so they decide they have to, you know, like, retrace their steps and think about what they're going to do next. So they decide to go visit Paul Rudd's brother and his wife. But on the way, they come across this commune where they have to spend the night. And that's pretty much where the story takes place. The plot in this movie is very, very simple. There's not a lot going on. And Jennifer Aniston, you know, she plays the same role that she always plays. But this one was a little better than most of her movies. Again, I had very low expectations for this movie, so if they made me laugh twice, I would have been happy. And I will be honest, I was laughing a lot in this movie. It's my kind of humor. I really connected with it, and I thought it was really good and funny. The actors in this movie and the characters made it for me, because without them, the movie would have sucked. But there were so many interesting characters, and for instance, Paul Rudd's brother's wife, her name is Michaela Watkins. She was on SNL a few years back. She was hilarious. I was like, who is this woman? She was so funny, making all these funny comments. I don't know if it was written, but it seemed like it was just very organic and real, and she just kind of ad-libbed things. She was probably the one person I really remember from the movie that I thought was hilarious. Even the brother was funny. Every character in this movie was really funny and really good. My movie theater was extremely ecstatic to see this movie. I have no idea why. They were a little too exuberant. They were like literally clapping during scenes in the movie and laughing and screaming, and I was like, really? It's not that funny. But I don't know, maybe they were in the movie or so, I don't know. It was really weird. This movie is definitely rated R, so just be careful. Don't bring like your parents or your elderly grandmother to this, because there is a lot of nudity, and it's literally in your face, and there is a lot of swearing. There's a lot of unnecessary language, I thought. I don't know. I mean, just because you drop the F-bomb doesn't make it funny to me. I feel like you have to be more clever than that. So they use a lot of language. That's one thing I didn't really care for in the movie. But overall, the movie was definitely better than I thought, and you should check it out. This must be the 20% of Jennifer Aniston movies that I like, so I probably won't like the next four movies of hers. So check it out, Wanderlust. Wanderlust. It's actually, wait, is it Wanderlust or Wanderlust? I think it's Wanderlust, W-A and, well, crap. So check it out, Wanderlust. Wanderlust. Jennifer Aniston always plays the same type of character, but you know what? That's a bad omen, right?